Titled Thunder Bay March by John O'Reilly. Every one of our bands have to play a march to start their set at festival. Every single band that goes, be it middle school or high school. So that was their march. The second piece they're going to play for you is entitled Medallion Overture by a man named William Hines, who is still alive and well, and is a composer from Flint, Michigan. Went to the University of Michigan, and he's written just a ton of great band music for high school and middle school groups. So Medallion Overture is a piece in three sections. Starts with a fast section, you'll hear a slow section, then you'll hear the fast section come back. And this is what is called our required piece that we have to pick off of the state list to play for the festival. So, Medallion Overture.
Thank you.
one more piece for you from the seventh grade band. And this is a piece by Mr. William Owens. It's entitled Zia. And I want to read just a little bit of the program notes for you so we have a little background as to as for the piece. It's called Zia, the Sacred Four. The Zia sun symbol originated with the Native American Zia Pueblo Indians located in New Mexico. The design reflects their tribal philosophy that all things in the universe share a common karma. The four directions of the symbol are of great spiritual significance to the Zia, as they believe man has four sacred obligations: a strong body, a clear mind, a pure spirit, and a deep regard for the welfare of others. In 1925, New Mexico adopted the Zia symbol as the official insignia of the state flag. So this piece, the third piece that we play, is a piece that I get to pick. For all three of our groups, we have to play March, we have to play a required piece off the state list, but then I get to pick something that I think showcases, you know, some of our strengths, a lot of our strengths, and something that I think the kids are going to have fun with, and something that is contrasting to the other two pieces. And so this piece is going to feature our percussion section. It's going to feature some really neat sound effects that you'll hear throughout the piece. It will also feature a flute soloist, which is Miss Leanne Fagan, in this piece, so we hope you enjoy it. This is Zia. Thank you very much. Usually at this time, we have some side performances of it. Tonight, we have lots of stuff going on. And so I wanted to take some time tonight in between transitions to just update you on our schedule for next Friday. And as well, bring you up to speed on some things that are going to be happening for our band students here over the next few months. First of all, for festival next Friday, I want to just review the schedule with you. And so next Friday, all three of our groups are going over to Montague High School. So this is MSBOA Band Festival, and that stands for Michigan School Band and Orchestra Association. That's our state organization for all things band and orchestra. And so every year, this time of year in the winter, all the bands that are member schools go to festival. And really, it's our assessment for what we're doing in the world of band. You know, we think about NSTEP, that where we you know, have our students test to get data on how we're doing in our core subject. This is kind of like our NSTEP for music. We go, and next Friday, our students will all perform in front of a panel of three judges in the Outstanding Auditorium, in Montague's Auditorium. Each one of those judges are going to critique them based on their tone, their intonation, how the blend and balance, our musical effects, all sorts of different things. And then there's one more judge when we leave the stage next Friday. They won't be done yet. They'll go to a site meeting room, and there's one more judge in the site meeting room, and he or she critiques our students on how they read music for the first time in 4 minutes. They'll get a piece of music they've never seen before. They'll get 4 minutes to look at it, and in 4 minutes they have to play it to the best of their abilities, like what you're hearing here on stage, and they get graded on that process also. So the four judges' scores are combined, and we get a division rating. The divisions rate from a 1 to a 5. And so that's kind of a, you know, general description of what festival is. It's a great goal for our students. All of our students are very excited to go, and they want to perform and do very, very well. And so it takes a lot of work to prepare for that. So next Friday, I sent an email out, and hopefully you all received that. And if you did not, I would ask that you please send me an email if you're not on the email list, so that I can give the correct email for you put in for our distribution list. Next Friday, and we're going in order that you're seeing tonight. Seventh grade band performs at 1:25 in the afternoon. We will leave the middle school at 12:15, get there at 12:30. When they are finished, the seventh grade is actually getting bused back to Whitehall Middle School. So they'll be back to the middle school about 2:30, between 2:30 and 2:45. So please plan on having a ride for your student, the seventh graders, at about 2:45 over at the middle school. This is open to the public. So if you're able to get off work or you're not working at that time, all of the festival performances are free and open to the public. So if you can make it over there, I'd love to have you there, and I know the kids would love to have you as well. The eighth graders, they perform at 4:10. They'll go with the seventh grade at the same time, but they'll sit in the audience and watch some of the groups before they perform. Same thing, eighth grade will perform at 4:10, they'll sight read. The plan for the eighth graders is to be back between 5 and 5:15 Friday evening. And then for the high school students, the high schoolers do not perform until 7:35. And so they're a little bit later in the evening, or the second to last group. But SEP for high school, their call time is 6 o'clock here at the high school. We'll board the buses, get them over there, warm up at 7, and then they perform at 7:35. So if we should be back between about 8:30, 8:45. We are using all of our percussion equipment at Montague, and all of the chairs and stands that you see on stage. So any high school parents that are here tonight, I sent an email, but if you're able to stick around after the performance and help load all of our equipment back on our band trailer, we need to get it back here Friday night. So that is a big thing that I'd like to ask for some help with. But that's our schedule, and so if you have any questions about that, please email me or call me. I'd love to hear from you. We also still need a few more chaperones to ride the buses with us next week as well. So if you have the time or able to take the time off, we'd love to have you come join us. So coming up next is our 8th grade band. Thank you very much. On stage now is our eighth grade band. Their march was entitled Power by Harold Bennett. It was arranged by Larry Clark. Just a really fun march in 6/8 time. We're having a lot of fun with that one. The required piece that the eighth graders will be playing is our next tune. It's called A Song for Friends by Larry Dane. And this is a contrasting piece to the march. So at the eighth grade level, especially after 1 year of seventh grade going, the judges are really looking for us now to be able to start playing in a real lyrical, smooth style. We love to play fast and loud all the time, myself included, but that's not what all music is. And so this is a piece that's very slow, it's beautiful, it's lyrical, so you're going to hear lots of beautiful phrases within our clarinets and our French horn. So it's a really beautiful piece entitled Song for Friends. So that the judges can see us playing contrasting styles, tempos, volumes, all sorts of fun stuff. This piece will also feature a soloist. This will be Mr. Michael Wright on the trumpet. You'll hear that in the middle section of the piece. Here is Knights of Destiny. Thank you. Thank you very much. We have one more ensemble for you, our high school symphonic band. And I have just a couple more things I wanna talk to you about that are coming up here in March. March 14th, I applied to our state organization, the MSBOA, to host a state qualifying event here at our high school. And so we were approved last year, and so we are going to be hosting. We are one of 11 schools in the entire state of Michigan on March 14th, hosting State Solo and Ensemble Festival. So that I'm really excited about that, really, really thankful. We have a beautiful facility here at our high school. We're going to be using the entire building. We're going to be using the classrooms, the stage, the band and choir rooms, the gymnasium. So basically what that means is all of the high school students in our district, and our district spans from Whitehall Montague south to Grand Haven. We're in District 7. It was all the way over to Central Montcalm, Stanton, Central Montcalm, and Greenville, and all the schools in between. And so all of the schools, the students who received a Division 1 rating at District Solo and Ensemble Festival 2 weekends ago, on the 8th, they qualify for state festival, and they can choose where they want to go. But we, all of the schools in District 7 actually have to come here to Whitehall. So we're really excited to host them. It's orchestra and it's band combined. And so on that day, we're going to have lots of students from around West Michigan and the central part of Michigan above Grand Rapids coming in to our high school. And I'm really excited about that. I'm really excited to bring people in from other parts of Michigan that may not have ever been to the White Lake area. And so on that day for you, high school parents, we're looking for some volunteers. My high school students are also going to be doing some work helping set up. But for that day, really, I want to encourage you to come and check it out. It's open to the public. There are performance rooms and classrooms, but you can go in and listen. It's free performances all day. You can hear anything from a percussion ensemble, actually in the band room, to piano solos here on stage. There will be string quartets and ensembles, and as well as soloists. And we have 8 events that are going from our high school, and I'll have those students stand and be recognized once our high school band is set. But again, that's March 14th. It's a Saturday. It'll start at 8 o'clock in the morning. If you can even come in for like an hour and listen to a few groups, it would be wonderful. And you're free to go about the building. There will be schedules posted all over the building as to who's performing when and what instruments and what ensembles. But again, it's really exciting for Whitehall to be hosting a state qualifying event for MSBOA. I'm really proud of that and really excited for that to happen. And so, come check it out on March 14th. We're going to have flyers from the Chamber of Commerce to encourage everyone after they're done to go and patronize and check out some of the restaurants that we have here in the White Lake area, so that hopefully we can bring more people into this area in the spring and in the summertime. So getting set up on stage right now is our high school symphonic band, and they will again play. They will also have 3 pieces prepared for you. When the curtain opens, we're going to need a few minutes to get set. We're actually going to be using the baby grand piano. So once the curtain opens, we're going to come out. We're actually going to take up there's 80 students in our symphonic band, so we're gonna kind of come up. It's gonna take us a few minutes to get set, but thank you for your patience, and we'll get started as soon as we're ready. Thank you. This is our high school symphonic band on stage before you, our third and final performance for the evening. Their march is entitled March of the Belgian Paratroopers by Belgian composer Pierre Leemans. It was arranged by Michael Sweeney, and it's just a really fun, light march that features our clarinet section on our woodwinds, so it's a very, very exciting piece. Our second piece for festival is our selected piece, actually. We're going to play our selected piece second. So it's a piece called Song for Lindsay by Mr. Andrew Boyden. He is a teacher and educator at University of New Hampshire. And this is a piece that he wrote for his wife, Lindsay. It's a love song. And it was originally a piano piece. And so we have three soloists in this piece. So when he was asked to arrange it for concert band, he put in three solos. Piano solo, which is played by Delia Gomez. We have a flute soloist, Annika Swope, and then there's a French horn solo, which would be played by Braylee Johnson. And so when he wrote this piece, he plays French horn, and his wife Lindsay plays flute. And so you'll hear the two of those solos separately, and then you'll hear the two of them played together in the middle of the piece. And so just a really, really beautiful, emotional piece of music, Song for Lindsay.
Thank you.
Wasn't that beautiful?
Yeah, congrats to our soloist, Brayley, Delia, and Monica. What a beautiful piece. We have one more piece for you, and this is our required piece for the symphonic band. It's called Joyful Variations. It is based off of the Ode to Joy, Beethoven's Ode to Joy theme. And so this is a really fun, again, contrasting piece. This is like our overture. Starts with a fast 6-8 section, then a slow adagio for popular middle section in 4-4, and then ends with a really powerful 6-8 section at the end. I would like to recognize all of our, we had a lot of students participate in solo and ensemble, so I'm just going to ask them all to stand to be recognized, but out of all, I'm going to ask all of them to stand. So if you participated in solo and ensemble, please stand up. Percussion, wave your arms if you performed in solo and ensemble. Can we give our solo and ensemble participants a round of applause? We had 8 of our groups qualify and are registered for state at our site, and that's fantastic. I'm really proud of that and really excited for our students to perform at that level. We also have one of our performing groups that was chosen for showcase, for Muskegon County Showcase, at the Fruenthal. Coming up is a trombone quartet. And so our trombone quartet is Alex Wynn, Liam Zegda, Rylan Bernhardt, and Mason Inman. They'll be performing at Showcase here in Long Beach. So, they'll actually be playing an arrangement of Bohemian Rhapsody that Rylan Bernhardt put together. So it should be a lot of fun, and they're having a lot of fun putting that together. Again, I want to thank you for coming tonight. Let's have one more round of applause for all of our performers, our 7th and 8th grade. We don't have refreshments for this concert. This is just kind of a, we don't have our 6th grade here, so just kind of a shorter version of our spring and winter concerts. So when we're done this evening, 7th and 8th graders are free to go. I am going to ask that the high schoolers stick around and strike the stage. The NHS induction rehearsal is tomorrow morning. And so the high schoolers are going to stick around just for a minute to clear chairs and stands and equipment before they take off. Again, if you have any questions about next Friday, please call me, please email me, talk to me here at the end of the concert. I'll be at the Viking Center. If you have any questions at all or you're willing to come chaperone next Friday, I really hope you can make it out. It's such a blessing to have our site 10 minutes across the river. So I hope all of you can make it out and support our students next Friday at Montague. So our last piece of the night, Joyful Variations.